Doing Bonanza, and we did it at Warner Brothers, What was it like when you did Secret of the Sword together?
Well, I think it was just really just like doing the whole animated series, because just as Alan had said, it was shot like a or it was handled like a television show or a film, because we would go in to read the script all around the round table. Then we would go in and do our work in the studio. And basically, with the Secret of the Sword, it was a similar thing, just to take time and think.
Yeah, they get a story that prints out when the winds went from Eternia to Imperia. It starts for his lost sister, Dora.
Yeah. it was very similar to just like one of the series, too.
Yeah. This vision wants to look at it. It's after watching He-Man Masters of the US season one, now Vision She-Ra season one. So I'm getting through it. But Alan, I want to ask you, how do you compare your voice of Skeletor to the Skeletor in the 2002 He-Man Masters of the Universe?
How would you compare your Skeletor to the Skeletor? The 2002 cartoon series.
Well, that's the one they did in Canada, wasn't it?
Yeah.
Well, what do you want me to say? They should have stayed here and done it with us.
Yeah.
They went there because it was cheaper and no residuals.
It showed the younger version of Chris Adam, who was younger.
I never saw it. I don't know how many people have really seen it. I guess you did.
I appreciate. I enjoy what you've done, and I'll keep watching. So thank you so much.
I'm not a big fan, by the way, of the serial version 2, version 3. I think the more you do it, and I think the first one isn't successful. Is it?
Yeah.
First off, thanks for a lovely gel that like some 30 years ago. But what was it like, you know, the toy line comes out with these cartoons. What's it like to have your projected likeness on these toys? Do you guys collect them, or do you just enjoy seeing them?
Well, I have some really, really old She-Ra stuff, but it's played with, so it's probably not worth much, but it was worth a lot to me. And just recently, though, I started, when I started coming to the Comic-Cons, I thought, well, I'm going to get a couple of these things. So I only have one little doll, the Funko doll, that's the only one I have. And I have the new doll that I got. And I thought, if I was a little girl, and so I think it's kind of cool to have all those toys like that. I really do. What really makes me happy, though, is that other people really find inspiration in them. I really like that, the best of all.
I have a set that I was going to give to my youngest grandson, who was 8 years old. And my daughter said, don't do it. I don't want to pick up any more things. So I still have.
What's your favorite super?
just a funny villain. What do you think?
Abu!
He's a hero to you. He's a hero to me. You betcha. You bet that's because you're here. That's why he's a hero.
He saved Christmas.
Thank you for your question.
My favorite superhero is Green Lantern.
Ah, Green Lantern,
yes. Which one? Really? Kind of like
they came up with and what they gave us is a basis, then we bring to it our imagination and personalities to the best of our ability to make it live off the printed page. But their original concept is what gives us the idea how to act it. So it starts with writing.
I see. Thank you.
Okay.
I think with the She-Ra, particularly the She-Ra series, because that was one I was most involved in. It's the values that we all try to express through that program. It's the inspiration that we actually gave to those characters to give to the audience, and the empowerment of it all. And the, I just hope that, I mean, I think you've all heard that there's a new series coming. I hope that they adhere to the values and the principles that we held in our series too, because if they do, it will be such a timely thing. And it can never be